really, really love photography. It was just something that Franny, my sister, and I took to from the very first moment.
Condé Nast, where I was fortunate enough to be hired in that one wonderful point I described, I really did all exclusively fashions and beauty, and sometimes reportage.
We were at Pratt together. We studied art. And halfway through Pratt, we got into photography, and that was it. We knew it. So we were very fortunate. We knew what we wanted to do.
No one was there unless they really knew how to use a camera and to order. That's the big thing.
It takes very hard, intense concentration. In fact, sometimes when I'm through photographing for a couple of hours, I feel like I played tennis, and then I'm hungry.
The movie is Twin Lenses, one of my favorite, twice the fun. You know, they used to have double mint, twice the fun. This is double mint, twice the fun, twice. Right here. And I have twice the fun with the two filmmakers here, the writer, Dennis Watlington, and Nina Rosenblum. Welcome to the Hamptons International Film Festival. It's a pleasure.
Right, little spot. Nina Rosenblum, producer, director.
And you are the writer.
Yes, and I am the writer.
That's right. It's unbelievable. And what brought you together was one of my favorite companies, the William Morris Agency. I asked off camera, I said, what brought the two of you together and the William Morris Agency? So, you see, the agents do bring people together.
they in this case, they did a
right.
wonder.
Well, you know, I mean, we were both a part of William Morris, and, you know, they do these packaging deals where they pluck a director from here and a writer from here and tie them up together. Nina had just come off of an Oscar nomination for a film called The Liberators, and she was hot, and TBS wanted to get in business with her. Wow. But once they came upon this project called The Black West, which is the history of black cowboys in America, then they were looking, as they normally do, for a black writer. And so they went through their thin bin of black writers, and they plucked me, and we met, and we've been making pictures for the last 16 years.
Well, I tell you, you really have a winner here. I had the pleasure of enjoying this one. And first of all, I'm going to, not to blow the thing, not that there's any great ending that's going to sort of have people say, oh my God, I didn't realize. But just to give a little thumbnail plot summary of what the movie's about.
Well, we tell the story of two of the most astounding women of the 20th century who broke through the solid glass brick ceiling in the fashion world of photography, fashion and celebrity editorial, to become two of the most tremendous members of the profession and of our heritage. And so it was a great pleasure because one of them is from Long Island, Catherine Abbey, and Frances McLaughlin Gill, her twin sister, had a tremendous career. They photographed from the time they were in college at Pratt, where they got the Prix de Paris, and they then went to work for Vogue. They got the Prix de Vogue, and they were set, but they had to fight every step of the way, and in the fantastic way focused, the things that they achieved, the quality of their work, we feel so lucky that we got to portray them.
And what the viewer enjoys is you see these two women, now they're up there in age, of course, and how feisty they are, and how electric they are, and the vision that they have, and the way that they kind of, one is a specialist of the glamour shot, and the other one is more the the robust going out and out in the field.
Sorry, the house going person. I see in my relationship to the film, right, when Nina asked that I write it. Now, I'll tell you, I know nothing about the fashion world, and in that world, I'm like sort of the proverbial lump of coal in the snowbank. You know? But what really drew me to this story and, you know, made me so happy to be involved is that their courage during the time that they started their career, and the fact that women being able to play up there on the top shelf was considerably rare, their ability to break those glass ceilings and ultimately descend to the point where both of them operated on the top rung, to me, that's an American courageous story.
Sure, and at a time when they had the group shot of all the photographers, they weren't even allowed to be part of it.
Right. Yes, at Vogue magazine,
like saying, you know, just
the official shot.
Hit further left, and you were out of frame.
Yeah, yeah.
And their work is unbelievable. And it's based on this this beautiful book?
It's based on this beautiful book by my mother. We're so proud of it because she's a tremendous historian of photography. She's a groundbreaker in the field. Mm-hmm. And she put together a traveling exhibition on the history of women photographers. And that's how we met Catherine and Frances. And when they asked us to do a film about them, it was a perfect next step for us.
Well, that's amazing. And your mom is Naomi Rosenblum.
And this is a book by Abbeville Press. And she did this after she did a history of world photography, Abbeville Press. So she's quite accomplished.
So begs the question, are you a photographer?
Well, in film, a little on the side. But film, documentary film is what happened to me because
You could see that look. Because basically, when you look at this beautiful motion picture, Twin Lenses, it gives you the feeling and the way you kind of throw in their work and the intensity of how it looks and it's beautiful. It really, you not only want to see it once, you want to see it at least two or three times because it's like having a good meal. You get satiated and then you want to.
And that has to do, essentially the reason for that is that are the two women. One of the things about documentaries is that they're only as good as their subject matter is compelling, no matter how well you craft them and so on. And these two women and the heights that they reached and the fact that it is enshrouded in beauty, all of that wonderful photography and the whole deal.
Sure.
I mean, we're just happy that we didn't screw it up. And set a proper showcase for them to get their thing off. And
it's terrific. It really is. No, and I think that as a biography of these two wonderful individuals, it really stands really tall. It's beautiful.
Thank you so
much. So what's next? It's here. It's having its premiere here.
Right. It's having its premiere here.
We're thrilled to be here because they're from this area. We have a lot of family in this area. Mm-hmm. And the Hamptons Film Festival is spectacular. Mm-hmm. I've been coming on and off from the very beginning, and it's grown into such a major
Let's
major
talk about that for a minute.
One thing I want to say in relation to this, though, it's always fun to sort of have a little piece of an icon receiving its due or their due.
It's and long overdue.
You know what I mean? But that's always there's a real kick in that, and we're happy that the festival provided the opportunity for this to happen.
A lot of that you hear, as two people that come out and enjoy the Hamptons, part of the Hamptons, what does it mean to you, the Hamptons Film Festival? When you honored us by having us have the first look at it, what went through your mind when you submitted this thing?
Me relative to the festival, first thing I was impressed about, because I'd not had an entry before, was how fast it grew over its 16 or 17 years of existence.
Right?
And so our work has been shown all over the world in a variety of festivals from the Berlin, countless.
Sure.
And so we understand what that's about. And I was really impressed with the way that the people respected the work they selected. And that means a lot to the people like us who, make these things. And if you do that sort of thing, and then you give the power and the influence of the area, then you'll only continue to get better. And I think they have.
Well, that's very good. I appreciate that insight.